Linux has grown to be the most popular operating system on Azure, with more than 60% of customer cores on Azure running Linux. And there are strong reasons behind it. Linux runs great on Azure. Microsoft is a major contributor to many open source projects, such as the Linux kernel, Kubernetes, and PostgreSQL. Microsoft now offers its own Linux distribution with Azure Linux, which is a container host for Azure Kubernetes services that is optimized for Azure. Many AI workloads on Azure run in Linux, including OpenAI and ChatGPT. You can choose any Linux distro you prefer, as Microsoft supports all major Linux distributions and has deep collaboration with Red Hat, SUSE, Canonical, and the broader Linux community. As we look at moving workloads to the cloud, there are three major categories of tasks that need to be accomplished, regardless of which tooling you choose to employ, and whether you perform a lift and shift or modernize as you migrate. First, you need to discover the systems and workloads you have in your environment. Second, you must assess whether these systems are in a state where they can be migrated and whether it makes financial sense. It may be more beneficial to retire aging systems or move to PaaS or SaaS solutions. Third, you need to perform the actual migration. Whether it's moving a VM to the cloud, migrating data from a database VM to a database as a service solution, or moving a Java application onto an Azure service like Spring Cloud or JBoss. Let's look at why you might want to use Azure Migrate for these activities. Azure Migrate covers the migration process end-to-end in a consistent manner. It has been most successfully used to migrate tens of thousands of Linux VMs. You get savings estimates and cost for optimal configurations that meet your performance needs. Thus, your deployments in Azure are cost-optimized. Azure Migrate also provides capabilities to migrate workloads such as ASP.NET apps, Java Tomcat, and Spring Boot apps to Azure PaaS services, such as Azure App Services, Azure Spring Apps, and AKS. And best of all, it is free. Let's see how you can use Azure Migrate through your entire migration journey and migrate Realm machines running Java Tomcat workload to Azure. We already have an Azure Migrate project that is connected to an on-prem VMware environment. With this setup, you can see a variety of servers discovered based on RHEL, Ubuntu, and other operating systems. You can also see server information, such as OS version, storage, disks, etc. You can also view the software inventory and web apps running on this RHEL VM. In the discovery, we discover the Spring Boot apps are running in the customer-discovered servers and list them at a server level. Here it shows that these are the two Spring Boot apps running in this machine, along with more details that we capture for an individual app. We can now also assess these apps for Azure Target, like Azure Spring apps. In the assessments, we show the app readiness to move to the Azure Target, along with its estimated monthly cost to run. We can also show why the apps are not ready or ready with conditions, so that customers can leverage that information to mitigate the challenges. Once you've discovered the inventory, you can generate a business case that can help you identify the benefits you can get by migrating to Azure. To do this, you click Build Business Case. Provide the name, target location where the details will be stored in Azure, discovery sources, which is appliance in our case. Now you can optimize your migrate settings to minimize cost or move to PaaS. Let's optimize the cost. You can select the discount you would have gotten out of the Azure Enterprise Agreement and click Generate. It might take a few minutes, so I have a business case ready for you. In this business case, you can view the estimated total cost of ownership of running the workloads and servers in Azure and the comparison of it based on the on-premises costs. You can also look at the detailed breakdown of the Azure IaaS and PaaS costs and review the cost assumptions taken for your on-prem servers and licensing. You can also export the reports that can be shared with your business decision makers to get closure on your migration decision. Note that the Linux license costs are assumed zero here, and the compute and storage costs are incorporated for the business case calculations. Next, to help you with your migration plans, you can perform Azure Migrate assessments that help you provide the readiness, cost benefit, and target path for the migration for each of your inventory items. To create an assessment, you click on Assess. Now you can migrate to multiple targets using Azure Migrate, such as Azure SQL, Web Apps, and AVS. I'll go forward with the Azure VM. And provide the name and the source of discovery. By default, the assessment performed is performance-based, analyzing the perf for the past few weeks with prevalent VM sizing and pricing settings. I can override assessment settings to change these settings as necessary. I'll continue with the defaults. Next, let me select the on-prem servers that I want to assess. I can view the OS and other details to help in the grouping, and then click Create. It should take a few minutes, so let me go to an existing assessment and show you what it looks like. Here you can see we have a detailed report of the Azure readiness, cost estimate, and recommended configurations for these servers for migrating to Azure. This information can help customers identify quick wins, close on the migration approach, and plan for their migration journey. Once the migration plan is closed, you can use Azure Migrate to leverage the plan and perform migrations as well. I'll now show you how easy it is to migrate your applications and databases running on Linux servers to Azure using server migration. To start, you need to initiate the replication process that copies your on-prem data to Azure. In this, we'll set our targets as Azure VM, the type of virtualized platform, VMware vSphere, and the appliance that was set up for discovery. Now we can import the assessment plan or select the server manually that I plan to migrate. I'll select my RHEL VM. Now I can choose my target settings. I'll choose my subscription, region, resource group where my VMs will reside post-migration. Then my VNet and subnet so that my VMs can communicate once they're migrated. I can choose to right-size the compute and storage settings to ensure that we get the best out of Azure. I'll keep the defaults compute and storage details. Next, I can choose to tag the replicated resources. And in the Review and Start Replication tab, I can kick off the replication process. Azure Migrate supports up to 500 VM replications at the same time. Now, the initial replication takes some time depending on the data. To speed up the demo, I have some VMs already replicated and ready for migration. Next, you can perform test migration to deploy the VM in an isolated test environment. This enables you to perform all the end-to-end testing, user acceptance testing, etc., to ensure that the migrated application is working as expected. And you can migrate to Azure with confidence. Once you're satisfied with the migration, you can clean up the migration and perform the final migration. Similar to test migration, you can perform the final migration. In this step, you can additionally choose to shut down the on-prem VM to ensure zero data loss as you migrate to Azure. Once you migrate, the workflow starts and completes your migration, and your migration completes. So in this session, we saw how you can use Azure Migrate through your migration journey to help you decide, plan, and perform migration. We saw how it was to migrate your RHEL VM to Azure. The customer journey, however, does not end here. Once you're in Azure, you can continue to optimize your infrastructure. You can leverage Azure hybrid benefits to reuse your on-prem licenses and save huge costs when in Azure. You can also utilize all the services and capabilities Azure provides. Thank you.